Hello friends, welcome back. This is Amit from Magnet and this is my first tutorial on Unreal Engine. So hope you all enjoyed this. So first take a look what we are going to create. So if you are new to this channel, I recommend you to check my YouTube channel and you will find so many videos related to Element 3D and some of the videos related to Unreal Engine. So if you like those videos, please do subscribe this channel and turn the notification on. And here is the name for those people who has already joined me as a member. So if you really want to support me, you can also join me as a member. So let's get started. So in order to create the scene, we need those assets and those assets are absolutely free. So I'll show you that how you can get those assets. So first I'll show you that how you can get those megascan assets for Unreal Engine. So here is the button called the content drawer. Just click on this and your content drawer is open here. So say you need some megascan content for your scene. So how you can get those content here? First select this content folder here and right click. And now you will see that add quixel content. If you install the quixel bridge for Unreal Engine, you will see this. So just click on here. And the quixel bridge will open. So we will use some this tundra assets here. So just click on here. And I have already downloaded some of those model into my project. So I'll show you that how you can get this. So let's see, we need this ground plane here. So just click on this. And here from you can choose the quality of the model here. So I choose the nanite. And you just click on this download here and it will take little time to download your model. And then you just click on this add button here. And after you see this window here, it ensured that the model is imported to your Unreal Engine successfully. So I use some of those model into this project and you can download all this and we can create the scene by using those models. Okay. So I am not using only the megascan assets to create the scene. So I'll show you that how I get other models and I also get some models from the marketplace as well. So once you go in Epic Game Launcher, you go to this Unreal Engine and then go to the marketplace here. So first you go to this browse option here and click on this Epic content. Here you find some free content for Unreal Engine and I'm using this girl model here. So just click on this and then you can add it to your project. Okay, so I'm using this project. So just select and add to the project. Okay, so this is from the Epic content and I'm also use some another object. So go to this free and go to this permanently free content here. And then go to this 5 number page here and you will see that landscape background. I'm using this, so just click and add it to your project. Okay, so this is how you can get that as well. And also I'm using some free and go to the free for the month and I am using this mid-level house models volume 2. Okay, and just add it to your project. So click on this and select the project that you are working on and just click on there, that is the add to project. Okay, so this is how you will get all the assets to build the scene. Now we are in UE5. So first we build the atmosphere and then we build the scene. So first you go to the file and create new level, and we use this empty level here and just click on this create button here. So here is our empty project, and now we're going to build the environment first. So in order to create the environment, first you go to this box here, which is the plus sign here. Click on here. First you build a light. So create a directional light. So this will be our sun. So first we make this as movable. So click on this. This is after selecting your light. This is the details panel, and it holds all the parameters for your directional light. So just select the light and go to this details panel and just click on this movable. Okay. And then you write here atmos. And make sure that you check this box, that is the atmosphere sunlight. Okay. And now we're going to build a skylight for our scene, which will be the light that is reflect from the sky. So go to the light and go to the this option, that is the skylight. Okay, so this will be our skylight, and it also set to movable. Just click on the movable and click on this real-time capture. Okay, and now again go to this button here and go to the visual effects, and first to create this sky atmosphere. Okay, this is our sky atmosphere, and you can see the sun as well. So this look amazing. Again go to the visual effects and go to this volumetric cloud, and it will create the cloud for our scene. Okay, and again go to this and go to the visual effects and click on this exponential height fog. Just click on it. Okay, so the fog look nice, I guess. And you can also replace the sun by pressing and hold Ctrl and L, and then if you move your mouse, you can see that it moving. Okay, so this look amazing. And now go to down here, after selecting the exponential height fog, go to down here and you will see the volumetric fog, and just enable this fog here. Okay, and now again go to this box and go to the visual effects and use the post process volume, and by using this you can control the exposure as well. So they select the post process volume, and it initially the post process volume works inside the box only, but we want it works in for entire world. So go to the search button here and type infinite, and when you found this infinite extent unbound, just check this box. Okay, and then we go to the exposure setting. So type exposure, and there is the minimum brightness and maximum brightness. Just check this box and set all those to 1 by 1. Okay, so now if you think that the sun brightness is little too high, go to the directional light and just disable the search here, and you can decrease the sun intensity by going here, that is the intensity. Maybe we change this to 5. Okay, and you can also increase the sun size by increasing this option here, that is the source angle. Just if you increase this, you can see that the size of the sun will increase. Okay, so you can increase the sun as you want. Okay, so we build the environment here. Now we're going to build a landscape for our scene. So for this, go to this select button here, that is a select mode, and go to the landscape mode here. Okay, so here is the landscape. We do not make a critical landscape here, we just make a flat surface here. So we just click on this create, and it will create the surface here. Okay, so as you can see, it creates a nice surface for our scene. So again go back to our main mode here. Okay, so let's see what we did. so far. First, we create a directional light which is represent our sun, and then we making a exponential height fog which creates a nice fog to our scene. And then we create a post-process volume which also handle the exposure as well as the fog settings. And then we make a sky atmosphere. It also make the background sky here, which is the blue sky, and the volumetric cloud which create this nice cloud here. Okay, and this is a skylight. This is a skylight which is comes from the indirect light from the sky. So this is our environment. Now we put the assets to make the scene. So first we going to create the distant mountain here. So I am using this photorealistic background here that we downloaded from the marketplace. So I am using this one. So just click and drag and drop to your scene here. And now this is a very big mountain here. So we just select this red axis here and just push it backward. Okay, just like this. And you can see that it looks nice in the background. So now we duplicate this. So in order to duplicate this, press and hold the Alt key here and just drag any axis, and you can download duplicate the model here. And maybe we can rotate this, and if you press E to bring the rotation tool here, or you can just toggle the switch from here and just rotate this in this axis. Okay, just like this. And again, if you press W, you can see that move gizmo here. And if you press R, you can see the scale switch here, just like the element. Okay, so now you can duplicate this one more time by pressing and hold the Alt key and just duplicate it into this side. Okay, just like this. Maybe you can push it little closer to make another dimension here. Okay, just like this. So you create a nice mountain background here. So now we going to put a surface here. So I'm using this Megascan model for this, and I'm using this surface. Okay, so just select, click and drag it to your scene here, just like this. And you can see it is also a very big model here. So right now we are in the bottom of this model. So if you press and hold the right click button here and press E, you can move upward, and if you press Q, you can move downwards. Okay, so this is how you can navigate. And if you want to move forward, you can press W, but make sure that you hold the right click button here. Okay, and also if you press S, you can go backward, and if you press A, go this left side, and D to go to the right side, just like the video game. Okay, so now if you familiar with the movement tool here, we can proceed to the further. So if you select this blue axis here, just click and dip it down to the surface. Okay, just like this. So you can see that it really a very big model here, very big surface here. So you don't worry about creating any further landscaping, because it creates a nice result here. So now if you select this mountain and duplicate this by pressing and hold the Alt key, and then you rotate this, it will also cover this side as well. Okay, and do the same for this side, but I think we don't need this anymore right now. So if you want, you can duplicate the mountain in that side as well. Okay, so this look amazing. So now we put some other objects here. So first we go to again content drawer here, and maybe we design our scene by using those models here from the Megascan. Just click and drag and drop to your scene here, and we rotate this into this side. Okay, and then we can duplicate this and place it here. So this is like that you can create, design your scene. And as always, I say that this is not specific, you can create your own design, but I'll show you that how you can manage and put your model into your scene. Okay, and if you think that the movement of the camera is little too fast, you can slow it down by click on here. It set it to 6, but if you decrease it to 4 or 3 maybe, it will move slowly. Okay, just like this. So I think it is move little too slow, so we can change this to 4 maybe. And now it can little bit of manageable. Okay, so this look nice. So now again we put another object to build our scene. So maybe put some this model, just drag and drop here, and now we can place it here, and also we can rotate this, and then we duplicate it by pressing Alt and place this here, dip it down. Okay, okay, so now we put something in the background so it can fill the gaps here. So I'm using this stone model here, and just move your camera here and place it little up, and also we can scale it up. So press R to bring the scale tool and select this white box here and click and drag, and you can see that to increase the scale by using that tool. Okay, so now you can place it here, or you can also scale it up by go to its details panel, and you can see the scale, and you can see that the lock is open. So first we lock this, and if you increase the scale, you can see that it uniformly increase the scale here. Okay, so now we place it at the background here. Okay, and also duplicate it one more time, and you can rotate this just like this and scale it up. Okay, so now you can make a nice field here. Okay, now we put some surface here, because this surface it looks like a very low in resolution, so we can put other surface to match the scene here. So there is the surface, just click and drag and drop here. Okay, and now place it little up, and you can see that it is looks nice, and you can also scale it up little bit, not much, because if you scale it up a little too high, the resolution goes bad. So first you rotate this and place it here, and then again you duplicate it multiple time to make a nice field here. Okay, so now we're going to use another plane here, so maybe this one, drag and drop here little to I, and then we again increase the scale and place it here. So now you can understand that how you can build this scene. Okay, so now again we duplicate it. Okay, so now you can see that it now looking better, and now again we can fill the entire surface by using this surface. Okay, so I am doing little quick here. Okay, so now you can see that it creates a nice field here. Okay, and you can also put another object into this side to fill the gaps here, and you can see that there is a gap here, so make sure that you fill that gap as well. So make it little higher, and also make it little higher too. Okay, now you can see that it's really bends here and nicely. Okay, so this look amazing, and now again we select this rock here and duplicate it and place it maybe here. Okay, so now you can see that it really blends here. So now we use some foliage here. Okay, so in order to put the foliage, we use the inbuilt foliage here. So the select this foliage, and now we have to bring the foliage that we want to put here. So for this I am using this mid-level environment, and one thing I have to forget to mention that if you select this folder, you can see those folder and you don't see the content here. And if you find the content, you can go inside the folders and looking for the mesh folder here. But if you set a filter here, you can easily find all the static meshes here. Okay, so how you can set the filter? So if you click on here, it will say that all those, that is, if you have some blueprint class, you can select this and only the blueprint class will show here. But we're looking for the static meshes. So if you click on this static mesh here, it will show all the static mesh that present in this folder only. Okay, but if you select this content folder here, it will show all the static meshes which is present inside this content folder, which is every static meshes will show in here. Okay, because we set the filter to static mesh. So just select this mid-level environment and select this static mesh. But if you don't want to make any filter, you just click on it and the filter will disable. But if you click on this, the filter will active. So we use some grass model here. So select this grass and this one as well and click and drag it to here. That is the foliage slot here. Okay, now you can see that those two grasses are here. So now we can back the drawer here. So first we set some settings here. So that is the brush size. If you select this paint tool here, that is the brush size. If you increase this, you can see that the brush size will increase, and if you decrease this, the brush size will decrease. That is the density, that how much foliage you want to be grow in one click here. So if you click in here, you can see that little bit of foliage grow here. But if you increase the density here like this, set it to 1, you can see that more foliage here. But you can see that this is still little too less, because we want to fill all the gaps here. So how you can do this? Because the maximum value is 1 here. So in order to make fill all the gaps here, you can select both of these here, and when you select this, you will see some options here as well. So now here you can see that other density numbers here. So it is set to 100. So if you set it to 500 here, if you set it to 500 here, let's see how much dense it will grow the foliage. Now you can see that it will create a nice dense foliage here. Okay, so maybe this number will work here. So let make some foliage here. So click the right click button here and press ASD to move your scene here, and now we can put some foliage into our scene. So just click and paint your scene here just like this. So you can see that the foliage is growing into our scene, and believe me, it look really amazing. Wow. So build some foliage into this cliff as well. So you can see that it also create the foliage into the cliff here. And the Megascan models is also programmed that only the foliage side will catch the the green side only catch those foliage, not this white part. So it is really creates a nice result, and you don't have to worry about it because it is pre-programmed like this. So just click and move your mouse to grow the foliage here. Okay, so we have enough foliage into our scene. Wow, you can see that it really creates a nice result. I mean, look at this. Okay, so we are done with our foliage as well. So go to our main panel here. Okay, so you can see that this side is look little empty, so I also select this rock model and duplicate it into this side as well. Okay, so now it creates a nice result. So now if you press Ctrl and L and move your sun into a desired position, you can see that it really creates a nice result. Maybe we can make something like dusk like scene here. Okay, so it creates a nice result. Okay, so now we put some visual effects here. So for this, we create a camera here. So in order to create the camera, go to this box again and go to the cinematics and create a cine camera actor. So in this way, you will create a camera here and just select the camera and go to the perspective and select this cine camera actor. So now you can select the camera. Okay, so now you can move the camera, and our camera is little zoomed out. So first you select our camera and go to this film back and set it to 16:9 DSLR. And if you think that it is still too zoomed in, so we can go to this lens and check this, the 12 millimeter prime lens. And now you can see that it is a very wide angle camera here. Okay, so maybe we can put our light into little top here. Okay, so now we can go to the camera again and do some settings here. So first we go to down here and go to the lens. First we go to this bloom effect and check this box. And if you change this to conventional, or you can go to the standard, you can get little bit of bloom here. And you go check this intensity, and if you increase this, you can make a little bit more bloom here. Okay, just like this. And now we go to the chromatic aberration here, and it is very important to make a nice organic scene. So check this box, that is the intensity, and if you increase this, you will get a little bit of chromatic aberration at the edge here. And also we select this and go to the start offset, and we can increase this value little bit. Okay, so in this way you will only get the chromatic aberration to the edge only. Okay, now we go to the lens flare option here and select this, that is the intensity, and you will see that it creates a nice lens flare to the sun. Okay, and if you think the intensity is too high, you can decrease the intensity to maybe 0.5. so it will decrease the intensity, and it will be very dynamic, because if you move your sunlight, you will see that the lens flare also changing the position. So now we make our scene look nice, and now we put the character here, this content drawer here, and go to this folder here which hold the character here. So but the character is not a static mesh, so we uncheck this static mesh here and go to the characters and go to the heroes and go to this folder. And if you go to the mesh, you will see that this character here. So if you bring this character here, so once you bring your character here, it will take little time to compile all the shaders here. So but you can still move your camera, but you cannot see the texture here because the shader is compiling. Okay, so it will take maybe 10 minutes to compile all the shaders for this character here. And now you can see that it really creates a nice model here. Okay, and you can see that it is lagging because I screen recording this, so it is a little too laggy, but maybe in your case it is move freely. So this is the magic of Unreal Engine, that you can create a very big environment, but you can visualize all the thing in real time. Okay, so we all done here. So let's make some animation to the character. So in order to make the animation to the character, first we create a sequencer here. So for this, go to this option here and go to this add level sequence. Just click on here. Okay, and it will say to save your project. So just save your project here. And now you can see that this sequence panel here. Okay, so in this panel, everything you want to animate, you can just drag and drop to this slot here. Okay, so first we bring our camera here, which is the scene camera actor. Click and drag and drop to this. Okay, so now you can see that it will create almost 165 frame long video here. So maybe we want a 24 fps video, so you can change the fps count from here, and you can change this to 23.976. And if it is a 24 frame, so say you make a 10 seconds long video, so you can change this to maybe 240. Okay, and now if you go in here and you can just extend the time by extend this red line here, and maybe we extend this to about this, and when you extend this, you can also extend your camera cuts. Okay, so just extend this as well. I'm moving this. So when you see this sign here, you can extend your camera cuts. Okay, so this is the camera cuts, and this is our camera, and here from we can animate our camera, and there is a transform. You can change the location of your camera from here like this. Okay, so but before we go in there, let's animate our character here. So in order to animate the character, you can also put the character file into this sequence here. Okay, so this is our character here. We just drag and drop to here. Okay, so now our character is here, and you can see it's moving. Now we're going to put some animation here. So in order to put the animation, we go to this track button here and go to the animation, and you can see there are so many animations here. Okay, so maybe if you select this idle here animation, and the animation runs from this time, but if you move drag and offset the time, you can see that moving that idle animation here, but you can see that the gun is little down here, so this look something weird. Our camera movement is little fast, so we slow it down. So you can see that the gun is here, but it not look right. So again we go to the animation and go to this plus sign here, and maybe we change the first, we delete this animation. Okay, delete this animation and go to the animation, and maybe we select the idle relaxed. So in this way you can see that it holds the gun and then it stand idle. Okay, so it look right, but what about the running? So we delete this animation here, and again we delete this animation as well. Maybe you can delete this as well too. So first we go to the track, go to the animation, and maybe we make some run like animation. So let's type jogging here, and you can see that there are so many jogging presets here. So maybe we use this jog forward. So just select this, and you can see that it is a loop animation. You can see that it's jogging. Okay, but you can see that it stand still in the place and the animation is looping. So you have to animate the character over time. So how you do this? So let's see that our character run from this side to this side. Okay, so first we select our camera and change the viewer. We uncheck this camera, just select this viewport here because we don't want to move our camera. So first we change the camera speed here. Okay, like this, and now we select our character here and press E to bring this rotation, or you can just toggle the switch here and rotate this angle. Okay, Okay, and now we're going to move it. So first we place our character, make a little room here, place your character here. Okay, and first you can extend the animation by just extend this just like this. Okay, and go to the very beginning here. Okay, and now make a keyframe here. So once you make a keyframe to the transform, it will make a keyframe all of this rotation and all the axis movement. Okay, so but if you want to make a keyframe individually, you can expand the transform and go to the rotation. You can create a rotation keyframe here as well, but I want to make a keyframe which can affect the all the settings, so I just select this transform and make a keyframe here. Okay, and if you want to make a auto keyframe, you can just select this auto keyframe here. And if you want, you know, a linear keyframe, not a exponential or easy ease keyframe, just select this keyframe and right click, and there is a linear keyframe. Okay, so just make a linear keyframe. And if you want to linear keyframe as a default keyframe here, you can select this and change this to linear. So in this way, if you make another keyframe, it creates a linear keyframe from the beginning. So now go to the very end of the time here, and now you can move your character here. Okay, so now if you see that your character is running, but you can see that the character is running backward, so we have to rotate this as well. So press E and just rotate this into this angle. Okay, so now you can see that if you select the sky here, it will remove the green outline here, the yellow outline, and you can see that your character is running, but you can see that it's the angle is very bad and it really looks weird, so you have to change the angle as well. So select and change the angle like this, and also go to the very end. And there is the character. Maybe we can extend the animation little bit. So now you can see that the angle is right. And if you play this animation, you can see that it moves nicely. But I think that the movement is little too slow. And you can see that the contact side of the leg and the floor is not matching. So one thing we have to do, that we can extend the animation area. So how we do that, go to the very beginning and press W and just bring it little backward here. Okay, and let's see if it is match the movement or not. So zoom in here and let's see if you play this. Yes, now it move right correctly, but you can see that it not follow the surface, so we have to manually keyframe this. Okay, so first go to the very beginning here and go close to the character here. So now this will be a time consuming work, because you have to go through all the frames and animate the character. So first you select the character here and press W to bring this axis, and now we going to keyframe every frame here and match the floor here. Okay, so how you can go through the every frame? So here is the option. If you click on this switch, it will forward to the next frame. Okay, so just click and let's see that when the leg touches the ground, just like this, you can just make another keyframe here. Okay, and if you think the snapping is too high, because sometimes the snapping is not work right, so you go to the snapping here. you go to the snapping here and just change this to 1. Okay, so now you can move nicely. Okay, just like this. Okay, so again do this thing. So go to the forward frames and see that when it touches the ground, just like this, and just make a manual keyframe here. Okay, so it will be time consuming work, but in the end you will get a nice result, and you can see that your character move with the surface condition. Okay, yeah, I'm not doing it right now because it will take little time, but you can get the idea. So now if you go to our main camera here, so you can see that it's running. Okay, so now time to animate our camera. So go to the very beginning here and select the camera and expand the camera and go to the transform, and now make a keyframe here, and maybe we go very close to our character here, just like this. And you can see that the camera angle is little very wide, so we go to this camera component here, and here you can see that the camera aperture, focal length, as well as the focal distance. So you can change the camera focal length, but you can see if you change the camera focal length, it not working. It's because that our camera focal length is set to a limited size here, that is the 12 millimeter. But if you change this to universal zoom, now you can move the camera focal length. Okay, so maybe you can make a 45 millimeter presets here. Okay, and now if you move the camera here, and now you can see that our character is out from the focus. So you go to the focus distance, you can change the focus distance by tweaking these settings here. And if you want a nice bokeh effect, you can decrease the camera aperture to maybe something 1 maybe. Okay, now you get a little bokeh effect, and if you just close to the camera, you can see that our character is in the focus. Okay, so it really creates a nice result. Now you can animate our character, animate the camera. So first you select the transform and make a keyframe. We already make a keyframe here. So, and now go to the very end animation here, and because we check on this auto keyframe here, so we just place our camera and it will create an automatic keyframe. So let's find our character. So here is our character. Okay, and we create a keyframe here, and the keyframe is linear. So now if you move your timeline here, you can see that it creates this animation as well as the camera movement. Okay, so sometimes you will see that it's lagging because it's rendering, or maybe I screen recording this, so it looks some laggy. Okay, so now if you can animate the character over time, it also follows the surface condition as well. Okay, so now you can get the idea. Okay, so now you can see that our camera animation is little too linear, so we're going to create some camera shake as well. So it is little bit too tricky to make a camera shake, but believe me, you can do this because it is not that tricky. So we're going to make a blueprint for our camera shake. So in order to do this, we go to our main viewport here and expand this content drawer and just make a blueprint by pressing right click here and go to this blueprint class. Just click on this. Okay, and you can see this panel here, and you can search for shake, and you can select this camera shake base. Okay, just select this and select here. So now I can create a blueprint here, so name this as camera shake, and never use the space button because Unreal not support the space button. So I'm using this underscore, and now double click on this. Okay, so you can see that here is the blueprint opens, but you have to close this for the first time and reopen this. Okay, so now you can see that it changes. So now we go to the camera shake pattern and go to the root shake pattern. Just expand this and select this parallel noise camera shake pattern. Okay, and now we go to the timing and change the duration to 0. Okay, so we all done here. So just compile this. So it is very simple, and just close this. And now we go to our main sequence here. So go to our sequence here, and now we're going to apply the camera shake blueprint to the camera actor here. So select the camera, go to this track and go to the camera shake, and you can see that the camera shake blueprint here. So just click on here, and you can see that the camera shake blueprint is present here. So now we going to offset the time here and expand this throughout the timeline here. Okay, so but you can see that no camera shake appear here because we have to put the values. So we're going to open the blueprint here. So in order to open this, go to the content drawer and go to the camera shake blueprint. Just double click on this. Okay, now we go to the rotation. So you can see that all this pitch, yaw and roll, expand this. And first we go to the rotation amplitude multiplier. So just make this to maybe 2 and frequency to 1, or maybe we can change this to 2. Now you can see that the camera shake here. Now it looks a little bit more organic because the camera shake really makes a nice vibe. That so it creates that the camera moving so fast, and it creates a nice camera jerk here. Okay, so in this way you can also create the camera shake. Okay, so this is all about the scene that I make, and I also make another camera movement. Maybe you can select the camera here, select the camera and uncheck this auto keyframe here, and if you just go here and down the camera here just like this, maybe we can delete all the keyframe that we just create, and maybe just select this keyframe and delete this, and select this keyframe as well and delete this, and maybe here you can see that the character is here. Okay, and now select the camera component here and adjust the focal length to focus the character here. Maybe you can zoom and also place the camera here and select the focus distance here. Okay, and you can see that the character is moving, and you can also make the camera to follow the character here just like this. First to make it here and make a keyframe here and go to this time and change the camera position like this, and you can see that the character is floating is because that make auto keyframe and change the character position here. So you can see that, and also you can move the camera and adjust the focus distance, the focus distance just like this. Okay, and now if you play this, you can see our character is here. Again we adjust the focus distance. Okay, if you play this, maybe our character is out from the focus. So make another keyframe to ensure that our character is in the focus or in the frame. Okay, so now you can see that it follows the character. Okay, as well as make a keyframe to adjust the focus. Okay, and also make a keyframe. Okay, so now you can see that the camera shake also looks perfect and our character is in the focus. Okay, so this is the scene and I hope you really get the idea and enjoy that how you can build something like this. So you can see that the camera shake really creates a nice result to our entire scene because it gives the life, and I hope that you get all the ideas. So everything is done, but now the real question is that how you can export this and how you get a nice quality of your render. Okay, so it is also important that you get a nice result and nice anti-aliasing. So how you can export this? So for this you have to enable a plugin. So go to the settings and go to the plugins and let's find movie, and you will see that this plugin, that is the movie render queue, and just enable this and also this additional render passes. Okay, so just enable this and now you will prompt that restart now. So you have to restart your engine here. So you have to save all this. Okay, so we restart our engine here. So let's render this out. So first you go to the Windows and go to the cinematics, and after you enable the plugin you will see that movie render queue. Just click on this and now you go to this render and first you select this new level sequence 1. Okay, and then we go to this unshaped configuration. So in default it renders the JPEG sequence, but we need to change this. So we select and delete this, go to this settings and change this to PNG sequence 8-bit. Okay, so now our render will be in PNG format. Again we go to the settings, go to the anti-aliasing, and here you can change this to 32. So I find this 32 is also good looking and also render fast and creates a nice result, but you can change this to 64 if you want a more nice result. Okay, so once you change this to 32, let's check this box, that is the override anti-aliasing. Okay, and now go to this anti-aliasing method. I'm using this multi-sampling anti-aliasing, that is the MSAA. Okay, now we go to this output, and here you can select the output path for your scene. Okay, and then you can change this, the custom frame rate, to maybe 23.976 or so. So that is the 23.976 frame rate, or you can change this to 60 fps, whatever you want. You can change the resolution to 4k or maybe, but I use the 1080p resolution, and everything is look nice, and just click on this accept. So now you can ready to render this out. So just render and you will get a PNG sequence, and after that you can import those PNG sequence into After Effects or whatever compositing software you have, but I use the After Effects. So in this way you will create this movie kind of animation here. So this is all about this tutorial, and I hope you really enjoy this. And this is a very big tutorial, and I go through all the options that I need to make this scene. So I hope you follow along and learn this, that how you can do this. So this is for today, and if you give me a nice response to this video, then I can also make another tutorial on Unreal Engine. So this is my first tutorial, so if I do some mistakes, just pardon me. So this is for today, and we will see in my next video. So till then, take care and bye bye.